I thought we might start our lesson today just watching this and thinking about some of our own prior knowledge, what we've learned about plants already, and see if there's some new things that maybe you didn't know. My name's Emery Futrell. I'm a 5-6 teacher at MacFarlane Primary School in Katherine in the Northern Territory. Prior to being a teacher, I came into teaching quite late in my profession. I was an environmental scientist in Queensland, worked for Queensland Museum and also Noosa Council. I think my inspiration for science came about that I could see that anyone can learn science. Science isn't something that we can't learn, and particularly with children from an Indigenous background, they really relate to science because it's around them. And they come up with amazing ideas. When we're working, we have a permaculture garden here, and we also have a bush tucker garden. Just some of the ideas they've come up in looking after the plants have made me reassess what gardening's about. And what our claim today is, plants grow better. Do they grow better in soil? And no answers yet, this is your thinking time. Do they grow better in gravel? Or would they grow better in cotton wool? When I teach science, I engage them first, then we do some explorations, and then we evaluate what we've actually done, and then I get them to explain what they've done. Often people do the explaining first and then the evaluation after. I do it the other way because, are we on the right track? Should we be changing something? And if students start thinking like that, science will become easier and easier as they go through the years of schooling. Most plants grow in soil. I wonder why. Think why. Why would most plants grow in soil? Let's have a think about that. What are we doing in the garden that helps our plants grow? Maybe that might help us think a bit further. We're going to explore how our plants are going to grow. Would Treb's group, Glendell's group and Greg's group like to go and put the amount of water they feel their plant needs and come back and see Miss Libby? You choose in the classroom where you want your plant to go. Where the sun is. Okay, this is what I want to see.
We partnered with the local land care project officer, Paula Maloney, and we also have Glenn Whiteman. He's a scientist from our Scientists in Schools program. They visit our school and they're able to pass on knowledge that these students wouldn't be exposed to.
Do you know the oldest science in the world? Do you know where it is? We always think of it as being modern, and it's to do with lab coats and test tubes and computers and chemicals. It's not. It's really old. So books like this with all the old Aboriginal science, that's the oldest science in the world. All the plants and animals, they got names, they got uses. Because the old scientists, all the old countrymen, they practiced and they tested, they hypothesized. They tested all the chemicals in the plants to see which were the good medicines and which were rubbish medicines.
Glenn would come down maybe 3 or 4 times a year because he's Darwin-based, and he would work with our students. And they identified a lot of plants in the bushland behind us, what trees to plant in our bush tucker garden here.
So I would suggest we put broccoli here. Never put plants in the same garden you had it the year before because the soil goes sour. Okay?
Which one is it?
This one here.
The garden is the centerpiece for our scientific work because they will have a knowledge base, and also it'll allow them to get work as rangers, they can get work in nurseries, in national parks, so it opens up their employment. I'd like to think everyone in my class by the end of year 12 will have employment and they'll have a knowledge base to use in a scientific field.
And remember Liz Clark, the horticulturist, said to us about, well, whether the plants might get too hot. How will we know whether their plants are going to be affected in this garden here with the black plastic? Sorry, put shade over it. That's a great idea,
like
Jordan.
What you said with them things there, we can just put it along the thing like that.
Yeah, we can do that. That's a great idea.
Green things there. Or that shade cover, just go.
Put the shade cover over
like
it.
Like
a tarp, yes.
It's also made our students very aware of the land and how we look after it. Because like I say to them, how you look after it today will affect your tomorrow. And the students really take that on board because some of our students here are going to be elders. So they need to know science to understand some of the documents that will be put on their land and be asking questions. And if they haven't got a knowledge base, how will they know the answers?